वंदे गुरु परंपरा श्रुति स्मृति पुराणानां आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। ॐ सहना भवतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः। यो ब्रह्माणं विदधाति पूर्वं यो वेदाश्च प्रणोति तस्मै तरुणदेवमात्मबुद्धिप्रकाशं मुमुक्षुर्वै शरणमहं प्रपद्ये। शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः। श्रीचिद्घनगणेशाय नमो। मह्यं सुखनित्यं सप्रकाशं व्यापकं नामरूपे अधिष्ठानं बुद्धिबोध्यं बुद्धेर्लक्ष्यत्वे निर्मलमपारं सर्ववेदान्तवेद्यं प्रत्यक्परं महः तदेवाहन्नमस्त्वन्यत्ति मे निश्चितामुचिः। Continuing in the fourth chapter. The Ishwara Sharira, when an avatar is taken, is also said to be Maya Karya. Rather, it is first denied as being Brahma. Then later, some vaishishtyam has to be specified between jiva sharira, prani sharira, and avatara sharira. To differentiate, there was an explanation given as to, with a Purana example also, that Ishara sharira is mayika sharira, avatara sharira, whereas the jiva prani sharira is bhuta karya, panchamahabhuta karya. And jiva, other differences were mentioned, that jiva is under the influence of avidya, whereas maya gives sarvajnyatvam to avataras. Jivas need mahaupadesha, mahavakya upadesha for jnana, which leads to moksha, whereas avataras have jnana due to there is maya vritti rupa, maya vritti being there. Jiva needs an antakkarana vritti, which comes about by acharya upadesha of mahavakyas, whereas maya vritti rupa atma jnana is there for avataras, and that is swabhavika. Svabhavata eva jayate natu upadesha manu. So upadesha is not needed. That is what we looked at in the end. Kintu na tena jnana kinchidabhi prayojanam ishwaranam siddhyati. Ishwaranam means avatarana. The avataras do not have any prayojana of the jnana which takes place, because swabhavika itself there is mayavritti jnana, and swabhavika itself they don't have avidya. So vikshepa is also not there. Avarana vikshepa not being there, even if there is svabhavata eva jnana, mayavritti rupa atma jnana, still it has no prayojana, because avarana need not be taken away, vikshepa is not deluding them. Tatahi jivasya ghatadi jnanena avarana bhango ghatadi rupa visheshya prakashascha iti phalam siddhyati. So for jiva, ghatadi jnanena avarana bhanga, brahma jnanena brahmavarana bhanga, ghatadi jnanena ghatadi avarana bhanga. So there is vritti vyapti ghatadi rupa visheshya prakashascha. Avarana bhanga is by vritti vyapti, and ghatadi rupa visheshya prakashaha is by phala vyapti. Iti phalam siddhyati. जीवस्य अहम् ब्रह्म इति ब्रह्माकार आत्म ज्ञानोदये तु तादृश ज्ञान विषयी भूतस्य आत्मनः आवरण भंग मात्रम् ज्ञानेन जन्यते. इन द केस ऑफ ब्रह्म ज्ञान व्हाट हैपेंस, देयर इज अ ब्रह्माकार वृत्ति. ब्रह्माकार वृत्ति टेक्स प्लेस बाय महावाक्य उपदेश व्हेन देयर इज अपरोक्ष ज्ञान. एंड ज्ञानोदये ब्रह्माकार आत्मज्ञानोदये तादृश ज्ञान विषयी भूतस्य आत्मनः विच इज द विषय फॉर फॉर दैट ब्रह्म ज्ञान इट इज प्रत्यगात्म इट्सेल्फ विच इज टॉट एज ब्रह्म. थ्रू दैट ज्ञान आवरण भंग मात्रम जन्यते ज्ञानेन. थ्रू दैट ज्ञान आवरण भंग takes place. Phala vyapti is not needed, only vritti vyapti is needed. Avarana bhanga is vritti vyapti. Because atma is swayam prakasha, we saw this yesterday as well, and multiple times we have seen it. Atma rupo visheshtu swayameva prakashate. So summing up what happens in brahmakara vritti, the guru tells tattva drishti that atma rupo visheshtu swayameva prakashate. You the atma who is non-different from Brahma, in whom there is prapancha, prapancha pratiti, due to avarana of your own nature, there is vikshepa in the form of prapancha pratiti, that goes away by atmajnana. How so? Avarana goes away by aparoksha jnana of aikya. Then Atma, which are you, you yourself are Pratyagatma, Brahma, who is Chaitanya Sarupa, therefore Atma Rupa Vishayastu Tvam Swayameva Prakashate, there you will shine forth on your own, really. This is the teaching, Tasmad Atma Jnana Vishayana Prakashate. There is no Phala Vyapti needed of Vishaya to be lit up, which is necessary in the case of Ghatadi Jada Vishaya. Evam Ishwarasya Aham Brahmasmi iti Mayavritti Rupa Jnanasya Vishaya Bhutaha Ishwarasya Atma Avarana Rahita Swayam Prakasha Swarupoasti. The Vishaya of Aham Brahmasmi Mayavritti Rupa Jnana for Ishwara, meaning for Avatara's Ishwara, Aham Brahmasmi is Swabhavika Jnana, which is due to Maya Vritti. Vishaya is Atma. Vishaya Bhuta Ishwarasya Atma. Rama, Krishna, they also have the Aham Bhava. That aham bhava pratyagatma is atma. Avarana rahita swayam prakasha swarupaha. There is no avarana. This is an elaboration. What we started with, it's an elaboration of that. Thereby, what happens? Avarana bhangova vishe prakasha. Tasmad avarana bhangova vishe prakasha va na ishwarasya jnanasya prayojanam. So to contrast with jiva, jiva needs vritti vyapti. Phalavyapti is not needed in Brahmakara Vritti. Whereas, in the case of Ghatadi Vishaya, Jiva needs Phalavyapti also along with Vritti Vyapti. So, in the case of Jiva, for Ghatadi Vishaya, Prapancha, there is Vritti Vyapti and Phalavyapti needed. In the case of Brahmakara, in the case of Brahmajnana, where Atma itself is the Vishaya, which is Swayam Prakasha, Vritti Vyapti is needed, Phala Vyapti is not needed. So Jnana has Prayojana. Not in the case of Atma as Vishaya, where Phala Vyapti is not needed, but Prayojana is there of Avarana Bhanga. In Brahmakara Vritti also. In the case of Ishwara or Avataras, Jnana has no prayojana. laukika, we don't need to focus upon. Sarvajnyatvam is there, but ghatadi vishaya is already known. Because avarana is not there and vrittivyapti is not needed, phalavyapti is not needed. But even if we assume that, okay, since there is the sharira in avataras, there may be necessity. Even if we argue about that, it is irrelevant to the context. Our focus is, in the case of Atmajnana, is there avarana and necessity of vrittivyapti? It isn't. So the difference between avataras and jiva is, in the case of Brahmajnana also, that being maya vritti rupa and ever being there, there is no necessity of vritti vyapti even. Phalavyapti is not needed for jiva also, because atma is swayam prakasha, but avarana itself not being there, there is no prayojana of jnana to Ishvara. So that is the elaboration here. Then, tasmad avarana bhango va vishe prakashva na Ishvarasya jnanasya prayojanam. It is just there. Sarvajnyatvam leads to sarvajnyatvam. Yatha jivan muktasya vidushaha. And in closing, the comparison is given that jivan mukta, Ramakrishna as avataras, Ishvara, they do not have jnana prayojana. Jnana is needed only for an ajnani jiva. As soon as that ajnani jiva becomes jnani, jivatva itself is gone, avarana bhanga has taken place, then the jnana which is there, which may or may not be swabhavika, but ajnana itself is not there, then jnana has no prayojana. Yatha jivan muktasya vidushaha. For the jivan mukta vidwan, avarana rahitam atmanam vishayi kuruvanti aham brahmasmi iti antakkarana vrittihi avarana bhangadi prayojana shunya bhavati. There is no prayojana of aham brahmasmi jnana anymore, because it has already done its task for a jivan mukta. That's why he is a jivan mukta. The idea of he itself is from the perspective of the onlooker. So avarana rahitam atmanam, that atma, pratyang atma, which is brahma, avarna rahita, needs no vritti vyapti even. So vishayi kuruvanti aham brahmasmi iti vritti, that vritti aham brahmasmi vritti, which is taking place in the antakkarana of the jivan mukta, because prarabdha being there, prarabdha shesha being there, the sukshma sharira continues to be there in the stula sharira. And the vritti aham brahmasmi taking place continuously or not, whenever it comes up, assuming that it is there, that point of time at least, antakkarana vritti avarana bhangadi prayojana shunya bhavati. It has no prayojana, it is just there because of so much of manana, nididhyasana being done. It remains, it comes up, or it remains continuously. And then it has no prayojana. It has already served its purpose. Prayojana shunya bhavati. Tatha eva. Similarly is the comparison which is given for Ishvara. Ishvara and jivan mukta have no differences in that sense. Tatha eva Ishvarasyapi avarana bhangadi prayojana shunyam mayavritti rupam aham brahmasmi iti jnanam vina eva upadeshadi sadhanam utpadyate. Jnani needs no sadhana, needs no upadesha. Ishvara never needed any sadhana or upadesha. The end result is same, that the aham brahmasmi vritti is prayojana shunya. Ittham Ramakrishna adinam jivad vaishishtya sattvena Ishvaratvam siddhyati. So the avataras are Ishvara because of the commonality shown between Jivan Mukta, avataras and Ishvara that the jnana is svabhavika, mayavritti rupa and has no prayojana. As opposed to jiva. So jivad vaishishtya sattvena. In contrast to jiva who has necessity of upadesha which leads to jnana, aikya jnana which leads to avarana bhanga, vrittivyapti, through vrittivyapti and phalavyapti is not needed. Then when this jiva becomes a jivan mukta, then this bheda between avatara ishvara or jivan mukta on one side and this jiva who is nama jivan mukta has switched sides where he does not need any upadesha to generate a vritti of aikya, and whenever that vritti comes up, even without the upadesha, there is no prayojana of that vritti because avarana bhanga has already taken place. Meaning ajnana is no longer there. Tathapi tesham shariram maya karyam. But still, we have to differentiate the sharira of Ramakrishna and jiva who may or may not become jivan mukta. There is a difference between their sharira as sharira of Ramakrishna the avataras or shariras are maya karya, whereas the sharira of the jiva who may or may not again become jivan mukta is panca mahabhuta karya. Ata eva na tat brahma rupam kintu mithya. So to come back and close the loop where we started, brahma na indriya vishaya, brahma na indriya vishayam, you can not vishayam, indriya vishaya, indriyanam vishaya na bhavati brahma. We started with chakshur indriya. Sadhu started with chakshur indriya vishayam, vishaya na bhavati brahma. So ata eva na tat brahma rupam kintu mithya. Shariram is not Brahma Rupa, therefore it is Mithya, not therefore, it is Kintu Mithya, but it is Mithya because of Maya Karyatva. Maya Karya Bhutam Avatara Purushanam Shariram Karacharana Dhyavaya Upetam Rupa Sahitam Cha Utpaditam. Sharira has Rupa, has Avayavas, has parts, Karacharana, all these parts are there. Even for avatara purushas, although they are maya karyas, still there are avayavas. Even if they are not panchamahabhuta karyas, still they are avayavat. Shariras are avayavat of avataras also. And rupasahitam chautpaditam tasmat tesham shariram netrendriya vishayatam apadyate. Sharira is Indriya Vishaya, although Maya Karya Bhuta, but not Brahma. Sharira is neither Brahma nor is Brahma Indriya Vishaya. Tathapi Netre Indriyam na Brahma Vishayi Karuti. Although their Sharira is objectified by Indriyas, currently Chakshur Indriya, still, Brahma is not objectified. Ramakrishna are Brahma. Their shariras are not Brahma. Shariras are objectified. Brahma is not objectified. Brahma tvagindriyasya vishayaha. So, is Brahma the vishaya for the sense organ of touch? No. Tvagindriyam tu sparsham tadashraya dravyancha vishayi karoti. So sparsha and tadashrayam dravya, wherever sparsha resides, the skin, so the touch, which is the guna of, whatever it is guna of, sparsha is guna of what? Of vayu. So it objectifies vayu. And objectifies vayu how? By objectifying the guna, sparsha. Sparsha is objectified. Vayu is not objectified. Akasha is not objectified. Shabda is objectified. Vanni is not objectified. Rupa is objectified. So gunas are objectified. Thereby, Twagindriyantu Sparsham Tadashre Dravyancha Vishayi Karoti Brahmatu Nasparsha Rupam Napi Sparshasya Ashreya. Whereas Brahma is neither Sparsha nor the Ashreya for Sparsha, being Nirguna, Atona Brahmana Twagindriya Vishayatvam. So Brahma does not have Vishayatva of Twagindriya. Brahma is not a Vishaya of Twagindriya. Then the others are put together in one avarta. Brahmana rasa rasana grana shrotrana vishayaha. What about the other three indriyas? Rasanendriyena rasa jnanam, granendriyena gandha jnanam, shrotrena shabda jnanam cha jayate. So each indriya has a vishaya. The sense of taste, the sense organ of taste objectifies taste. The olfactory organ through which you smell gandha objectifies gandha. So gandha jnana is born due to the olfactory organ. The knowledge regarding shabda is born through shrotra indriya. Whereas Brahma is nirguna. You've already seen that rasa gandha shabdebhyo vilakshanam Brahma. Brahma is neither rasa, is none of the rasa gandha shabda. Is none of the gunas. Tasmad rasana ghrana shrotraihi brahmano jnanam na jayate. Therefore, brahma jnana is not born through any of these three indriyas either. And what is the shruti pramana for that? Ashabdam asparsham arupam avyayam tatharasam nityam agandavachayat. Says Katopnishad, this Brahma is Ashabda, Asparsha, Arupa, Avyaya, Arasa, is Nitya and Agandha. What do we need? We need Ashabda, Asparsha, Arupa, Arasa and Agandha out of that mantra. Therefore, Brahma cannot be objectified by any of the Pancha Jnanendriya. And Paranchikhani Vyatranat Swayambhu. Tasmat parang pashyati antaratman. There is a katha mantra which says that the indriyas are tuned outwards, towards the vishayas. Brahma is not a vishaya of indriyas. Brahma is all pervasive but initially taught as pratyangatma. So pratyangatma cannot be objectified by indriyas, indriyas being focused outwards. When indriyas are drawn within, not that when they are drawn within, they are going to objectify Atma, but when they are drawn within, it gives an opportunity for the Buddhi to inquire into Atma. When Indriyas are outwards, then the Mana is also hijacked. Manas is hijacked by the Indriyas, comes under the influence of Vishaya, thereby Buddhi does not get enough bandwidth to work on Atma Jnana. And this is natural, therefore, Brahma, Chaturmukha Brahma, Ishvara as Chaturmukha Brahma, when he created Jiva Sharira, associated the Jiva with a particular Sharira based on that Jiva's, his or her karma. That time he tuned the Indriyas outward because the Jiva wanted Vishaya Bhoga and as though destroyed. Paranchikhani Vyatrunat Swayambhu, Swayambhu Ishara, Swayambhavati iti Swayambhu. One who is born on his own. Who tuned the Indriyas. Paranchidi, Golakas basically, Khani or Golakas, Paranchidi are outward, not Pratyang but Parang, tuned outward, thereby Vyatranath as though destroyed, not really destroyed, he blessed the Jiva for the Bhoga that he was craving. And thereby, if you look at it, the prayojana, purushartha, needs a lot of effort on the part of the jiva, thereby destroyed, because initially itself you are set up to fail. Jiva is set up to fail, is tuned so that he misses. You know, blindfolded and let out, blindfolded with the avarna, which has always been there. So it is a figurative rhetoric. Therefore, tasmat parang pasyati nantaratmam, does not see the atma which is within, pratyak, but looks at vishaya which are parag. Ityadina brahmana indriya avishayatvam bodhyate. Through these mantras, Shruti Pramana, Brahma being indriya avishaya is revealed. Brahma karmendriyana api avishaya. Okay, jnanendriya vishaya Brahma isn't. How about karmendriya? Karmendriyam na jnana sadhanam. They are not jnana sadhanam. Therefore, not being the means for knowledge, they cannot lead to Brahma jnana. It is but obvious. They are karma sadhana, natu jnana sadhana. Kintu vachanadi kriya sadhanam. Kriya sadhana. Karma as in not in vyakrana karma. Karma as in punya papadi karma. Which is otherwise called as kriya. Vyakrana will call it as kriya. So, kintu vachanadi kriya sadhanam. They are organs of speech. They lead to kriya of speaking, grasping, moving, and so on. Tasmat karmendriyaihi, pancha karmendriyaihi, na kasyachidapi jnanam jayate. So, not even for a single person, karmendriya can lead to jnana. So, it is not even an option. Prapta seva pratisheda. This is not even prapta, says, if at all someone thinks it is not prapta. To do nisheda, itham na kenapi indriyena brahmano jnanam jayate. It is not even prapta. No vishaya is known through karmendriya. Therefore, Brahma is also not known through karmendriya. We don't even need to inquire into it. Indriya janyam eva jnanam pratyaksham ityuchyate. And pratyaksha, now this is, the last part is, tattva drishti's question. It's a pura paksha. Indriya janyam eva jnanam pratyaksham ityuchyate. You explained that indriya is a pramana in the case of pratyaksha prama. So, pratyaksha pramanam is indriya. And indriya are 10 karmendriyas, jnanendriyas. Karmendriyas cannot objectify or lead to, they cannot lead to any jnana. And the pancha jnanendriyas cannot be sadhana for Brahma jnana, because Brahma is not their vishaya. You explained this. Then, indriya janyam eva jnanam pratyaksham ityuchyate. You have explained it. That being so, tatra evam sati, Brahma not being vishaya for indriyas, Brahma jnana is not indriya janyam. Then how can it be pratyaksha? How can one ever have sakshatkara of Brahma? Tadeva aparoksham iti cha kirtyate. So you may not call it as pratyaksha jnana, you may not call it as sakshatkara, you may call it as aparoksha jnana. But still, what is aparoksha? What is pratyaksha is aparoksha. Pratyaksha is indriya janya. Brahma is not indriya vishaya. Therefore, there cannot be pratyaksha jnana of Brahma. Thereby, there cannot be aparoksha jnana of Brahma. Tasmat brahmano aparoksha jnanam naiva sambhavati. There is no possibility of brahma jnana at all, because aparoksha jnana is needed. Aparoksha jnana itself is not possible. This is the last objection, so to say. Shabdena tu. Now you have said that shabda pramana is there. But yato vacho nivartante aprapya manasasa, there is a shruti. So shabda vishaya also, shabda also cannot objectify Brahma. Shabdena tu yadyapi brahma jnanam utpadyate, although there is a possibility of shabda leading to brahma jnana tathapi shabda jnanasya parokshatvat shabda janya brahma jnanam paroksham bhavet. It cannot be aparoksha still. Why? Because shabda jnanasya parokshatvat. Shabda jnana is paroksha jnana. It is not aparoksha jnana. But we have seen the dashamastvam, dashamastvamasi. There we have seen that aparoksha jnana is there. Why? Because Brahma, in that case, dashama asti jnana leads to paroksha jnana. But dashamastvamasi will lead to aparoksha jnana because he just has to drop off the search, drop off the grief because the tenth happens to be the very same leader. Very same person. Who is ever aparoksha? What has taken place then? Even when the Dashamaha was thought to be drowned and Mamara, Dashamaha, Mamara, it's already dead. Even in that grief of misunderstanding of the tenth not being there, even then the 10th was aparoksha. The 10th was aparoksha, but the jnana of the dashama. Dashama was aparoksha, but jnana of dashama was not aparoksha. It was not even paroksha till someone tells them that the 10th exists. Dashamaha asti. Then it is paroksha. Not that dashama is paroksha. When paroksha jnana isn't there, aparoksha jnana isn't there, even then, Dashamaha is Paroksha. The Vastu is Aparoksha. Dashama is Aparoksha. Jnana isn't there. Neither Paroksha nor Aparoksha Jnana is there about Dashama. When Dashama Asti Jnana takes place, someone says, no, there is, don't grieve, there is a tenth. Oh, okay. But still the grief is not completely gone. Because if the person is missing, this fellow is not only answerable, which may be a later thought, but there is a grief of someone missing. He is there somewhere else. He is not here though. But when Dashamaha Asti Jnana takes place, that time also the Dashama is Aparoksha. But the Jnana is Paroksha now. Jnana is not Aparoksha. Second stage. Third stage is when there is Aparoksha Jnana. Dashamas Tvamasi. You are that. That time Atma, Dashamaha Atma, reflects you. He knows that I am that tenth, that Atma, Dashamaha, is, which was ever Aparoksha, is still Aparoksha. Jnana is also Aparoksha. It is no longer Paroksha. Jnana is Aparoksha. Similarly, in the case of Brahma Jnana, Brahma is always Aparoksha as Atma, Ahantaya. Aham, aham, iti. Iti ritya. In that manner, Brahmatma is ever aparoksha. Brahma asti jnana, when it comes in, then Brahma is aparoksha as atma, as aham, but jnana is paroksha. Brahma jnana is paroksha. Somewhere, Brahma is there, as revealed by the Shruti. But then when Tattvamasi Jnana takes place, leading to Aham Brahmasmi, then Brahma, which was ever Aparoksha as Atma, also Jnana taking place leads to Aparokshatva of Jnana also. Because it is Brahma Ahamasmi. So the Jnana is no longer Paroksha. Atma, Brahmatma was ever Aparoksha. Now Jnana is also Aparoksha. This is the technicality of Brahma Jnana. Tasmad Brahmano Aparoksha Jnanam Naiva Sambhavati, if you say, and Shabdenu Yadyapi Brahma Jnanam Utpadyate Tathapi Shabda Jnanasya Parokshatva Shabdajanya Brahmajnanam Parokshameva Bhavet. If Sattvadrishti thinks that it is not so, Purvokta Prashnasya Uttaram. There is an explanation given answering how Brahmajnana can be Aparoksha, Pratyaksha. Sukadukhade Sakshibhasyatvad Indriya Sambandham Vina Pratyaksha Jnanam Na Jayate Iti Niyamo Nasti. Takes an example which is well known. Sukha dukkha, is it indriya janya? It isn't indriya janya. It is sakshi bhasya. Does not need antakkarana vritti. It is through avidya vritti. Sakshi bhasya tva indriya sambandham vina pratyaksha jnanam na jayate. Iti niyamo nasti in the case of sukha dukkha also. Then why do you insist in the case of brahma jnana? Indriya sambandham vina pratyaksha jnanam na udeti iti niyamo nasti. Sukha dukkha is pratyaksha to you. It is aparoksha, it is pratyaksha to you without the indriya sambandha with sukha dukkha vishaya. Sukha dukkha is the vishaya. The sukha dukkha may have come up due to some vishaya sambandha of the indriya. That is different. But do you know, that time you know the vishaya, which is ghatapatadi vishaya. Ghatapatadi vishaya leads to sukha dukkha. That is possible. Sukha sadhanam, dukkha sadhanam. This is due to misunderstanding. Due to misplaced ananda elsewhere, sukha dukkha elsewhere. But the sukha dukkha which is known, not the vishaya known. As a vishaya in ghatapatadi vishaya known, sukha dukkha becomes vishaya. Then the sukha dukkha is known without the indriya sambandha with sukha dukkha. Therefore, indriya sambandham vina pratyaksha jnanam na udeti iti niyamo nasti. Example being sukha dukkhadi. Sukha dukkhadehe jnanam na kenapi indriyena janyate. Tathapi sukha dukkha can be said to be indriya janya. One may say for the sake of argument, but sukha dukkhadi jnana cannot be said to be indriya janya. Tathapi sukha dukkhadir jnanam pratyakshameva. You cannot say that someone, in fact, it is only pratyaksha. No one else can tell you that you are happy or sad. They can say that you appear to be happy or sad. They don't know. They cannot have pratyakshikaran of your sukha dukkha. But you have pratyakshikaran of your sukha dukkha. You may put a smile on the face, but you know within you are dukhi. There may be a happy incident, you are happy, you go to narrate to a friend who is in dukkha, you can't narrate. So you have to show dukkha, there will be dukkha also within. But then initial happiness may be so much that dukkha isn't theirs as much. The other's dukkha may not be so much. So you start by expressing sadness outward. Within there, you know that you have sukha which is lingering on. Then the strength of the dukkha of your friend overpowers the sukha, you cannot be happy anymore. So it replaces the sukha vritti. So you know within as to whether you are sukhi or dukhi. Tasmad indriya sambandha janyan jnanam eva pratyaksha jnanam iti na niyamah. There is pratyaksha jnana of sukha dukha to you. Kintu yada visheena vritti sambandha vishayakara bhavati tada pratyaksha jnanam jayata ityuchyate. Vishaya has sambandha. Kintu yada visheena vritti sambandha vishayakara bhavati. When vritti connects with the vishaya and becomes vishayakara. So the vritti takes place in the case of here sakshi bhasya. So there is a vritti taking place, but the vritti has vishaya as sukha dukkha without the indriyas. Thereby pratyaksha jnanam jayate iti uchyate. Because the vritti is vishayakara, here sukha dukkha dyakara, because of vishaya sambandha of the vritti, does not need to go out, it is within. Then pratyaksha jnanam jayate iti uchyate. Visheena sa vrittehe sambandha kvachit indriya dvara bhavati kvachitcha shabdena bhavati. Sometimes it is through indriya, sometimes it is through shabda. Dashamastvam asi ityatra shabda jayamana antakkarana vrittihi dashamena swatmana sambandha dashamakara bhavati. We have seen this in the example of dashama. Dashama is the listener himself. So when the shabda jnana takes place, he hears dashamas tomasi. Then shabda bodha, which takes place there, what is the vritti taking place due to? Vritti has sambandha with it, dashama. Dashama is the vishaya who happens to be swatma, one's own self. Reflexive here, I myself, the listener, leader, am the tenth. Therefore, vritti is connected with me. Swatmana sambandha dashamakara bhavati. It becomes dashamakara as per the vakya dashamastomasi. Tasma shabda janya dashamajnanam api pratyakshameva. So, although shabda janya, not indriya janya, still it is pratyaksha jnana in the case of dashamastomasi. Similarly, tatha eva in the case of brahma jnana, we look at the tippana and further into the moola in the next part. Sukam nityam swaprakasham vyapakam namur adhishthanam buddhya bodhyam buddher dukkhet nirvana param sarvedanta vedyam pratyak paramaha tadeva anumattvanyat iti me nischitamatihi. I'll see you in the next part. If you have any questions, ask tomorrow or in on WhatsApp. Namaste.
Hari Om.
Hari Om.